today's video, I'm going to explain partial fractions when the denominator contains repeated linear factors. See here, this is the partial fraction, whereas in the denominator, x minus 1 is repeated for 3 times. So in this case, how to resolve into partial fractions? See here, a by. So it is resolved for 3 times. So I can write as x minus 1 power 1. And next one, b by, this is again x minus 1 power 2, and c by x minus 1 power 3. So this is how we have to resolve. This is most important. And when the denominator contains repeated linear factors, if it's repeating for 3 times, so we have to take 3 constants, power 1, power 2 and power 3. And now we have to resolve as usual. So here, this is x square minus 3x plus 3 by x minus 1 whole cube is equal to, if I take x minus 1 whole cube as LCM, see here, a into, so there is one term, so here there are three terms, two terms are missing, so x minus 1 whole square plus, this is b times of, here there are 2x minus 1 and here there are 3, so 1 is missing, x minus 1 power 1. Plus c times of, here they are x minus 1 whole cube, here also x minus 1 whole cube, that is c into 1. And now I can easily cancel x minus 1 whole cube on both sides. So if I cancel, see what happens, this is x square minus 3x plus 3 is equal to a into x minus 1 whole square plus b into x minus 1 plus c. So in order to make this one 0, I have, here there is minus 1, so now if I put x is equal to plus 1, then see what happens here. So this is 1 minus 3 plus 3 in place of x. If I substitute x is equal to 1, see what happens, this is 1 minus 1 whole square plus b times of 1 minus 1 plus c, and this is 1 minus 1 0, this is also 0, therefore, and even I can cancel this plus 3 and minus 3, therefore here it is 1 and here it is c, therefore c is equal to 1 is the constant. And next one, what we have to compare, so we have to compare. And the next thing is, we have to compare the highest degree. Here, highest degree is 2. On comparing with x square terms. On comparing x square quotients on both sides. So, while comparing, see, this is x square. The question here is x square minus 3x plus 3 is equal to a into, if I expand this, a minus b whole square. So, this will be a square plus b square minus 2ab plus, this is b into x minus 1 plus c. So, when I compare both sides, x square terms, here there is x square. So, it is, the quotient of x square here is 1. And here the quotient of x square is a, and there is no other x square term. Therefore, straight away we got a is equal to 1. So here a is equal to 1. Next, on comparing x quotients, this time, on comparing x quotients on both sides. See here, there is x quotient here. And there is x term here. So when I compare, so this is minus 3. See here, this is minus 3, and from right hand side, this is x terms is minus 2. If I multiply, this is minus 2a, and quotient of x here is b. So we have a value as 1. So if I substitute, that is minus 2 into 1 plus b. See here, this is minus 3 is equal to minus 2 plus b. This is minus 3 plus 2 is equal to b, and b value is equal to minus 1. See here, a, b, c are ready with us. Therefore, we have to substitute here in place of a as 1, in place of b as minus 1, and in place of c as 1. See, our question will become x square minus 3x plus 3 by x minus 1 whole cube is equal to, in place of a, this is 1 by x minus 1 power 1, and next b, what is b here, b value is minus 1 by x minus 1 whole square, and c by this is x minus 1 whole cube. So this is how we have to solve. So when the denominator has repeated linear factors, we have to split or resolve this partial fraction as three factors. As it is repeated for three times, so we need three constants. So this is how we have to solve. And the next equation here is x by x plus 3 whole square. So how to resolve this? As there are 2 x plus 3 terms, so x plus 3 is repeated for 2 times. Therefore, we need 2 constants, that is a by x plus 3 power 1. And next one plus b by, this is x plus 3 whole square. And now x by, this is x plus 3 whole square is equal to, if I take x plus 3 whole square as an LCM, see here, this is a into, there are 2 terms here, whereas in the denominator there is only 1 term. In order to balance, so I have to multiply with x plus 3 plus 3 b into, here there are 2 terms and here there are 2 terms, there is nothing we have to multiply. Therefore, now I can easily cancel x plus 3 whole square on both sides, and what remains? So x is equal to a into x plus 3 plus b. Now we need the value of a as well as b. For getting a and b values, so here there is plus 3. So in order to make it 0, I have to keep x value as minus 3. So if I keep minus 3 in place of x, so this is minus 3 plus 3 plus b. As you know that minus 3 and plus 3 got cancelled, and b value is equal to minus 3. And the next one here, how to find out? Now I have to compare x quotients on both sides. On comparing, see here, on comparing x quotients, on comparing x quotients on both sides, here the quotient of x is 1 and here the quotient of x is a. Therefore 1 is equal to a. Here the quotient of x is 1 and here the quotient of x is a. Straight away we got a value as 1. So if I substitute in this equation, see what happens, that is x by x plus 3 whole square is equal to a by x plus 3 plus b by x plus 3 whole square. So here I can substitute as x by x plus 3 whole square is equal to, in place of a, 1, and in place of b it is minus 3. So this is how we have to resolve into partial fractions while there is a repeated linear factors. So here there is another question. So this is 2x by x square plus 2x plus 1. So this is nothing but a square plus b square plus 2ab. So this can be written as x plus 1 whole square. So this is a square, this is b square plus 2 into a into b. Clear? So this is 2x by x plus 1 whole square. If you observe this one, the linear factor is repeated for 2 times here. So when it is repeated, so we have to use, for 2 times we have to use 2 constants, that is a by x plus 1 power 1 plus this is b by x plus 1 power 2. If there is 3, so we have to add one more constant. Now I have to take LCM for balancing. So 2x is equal to x plus 1 whole square is equal to, here also x plus 1 whole square. So there are 2 terms here, there is a single term. In order to balance, I have to multiply with x plus 1 power 1, and here there are 2 terms and here there are 2 terms, so into 1. So now if I cancel x plus 1 whole square on both sides and see what happens. So what remains? 2x is equal to, this is a into x plus 1 plus b. So in order to make this 0, there is plus 1 here, so I have to put x value is equal to, put x is equal to minus 1. So if I keep minus 1 here, see a into minus 1 plus 1 plus b. So minus 1 and plus 1 is 0. Therefore, this is minus 2 is equal to b, and b value is equal to minus 2. And after getting the b value, next what we have to do? So here the highest degree term is x, and a value is automatically 2. So now we have to compare. On comparing the highest degree is 1 here. So on comparing the x quotients, x quotients on both sides. On both sides. Here the quotient of x is 2 and here the quotient of x is a. Therefore, 2 is equal to a and a is equal to 2. Now we have to substitute the values of a and b here. That is, here see 2x by x plus 1 whole square is equal to a by x plus 1 plus b by this is x plus 1 whole square. See, in place of x, that is 2x by this is x plus 1 whole square. What is a here? 2. 2 by this is x plus 1, whereas b is equal to minus 2, that is x plus 1 whole square. And this is how we have to solve. This is so simple. If you practice, definitely you can solve by your own. And I'll be uploading many more videos related to these partial fractions. Please practice all those and you will be perfect. Thank you so much.